Assalamu alaikum, my dear students and my viewers. I welcome you to my channel, Learn English with Faisal Hamid. अगर आपने चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो जल्दी कीजिए, लेकिन वीडियो देखने के बाद. Today's topic is reading comprehension skills. Before that, we talked about reading comprehension, and in which we talked about the most important technique that is called scanning. So today we are moving forward and we are going to learn another skill, that is how to preview and predict a book. Obviously, you are going to apply that technique, scanning here, and then you will decide what to do. So now we move to our first slide. First, we need to understand what is previewing and what is predicting. These are two verbs. So, previewing. Always remember, our title of the lecture shows that we are going to preview and predict a book. Means we are going to observe a book. We are going to read a book. And then we will decide either we should read it or not. Right, so previewing is, it's a skill, it's a reading skill. So what is it? When you read external cover of a book and gather information, this skill is called previewing. So you're not going to open the book, okay? Remember, you are not going to open the book. What you are going to do, you are going to view only the external cover of a book, front and back. Second skill, second technique is predicting. When you guess what you will read in the book, this skill is called predicting. So you will observe and then you will predict what you are going to read, what you will have in this book. Either you will like it or you don't like it. Either it will suit you or it will not suit you. Either it benefits you or it doesn't benefit you. All right? So now we are going to see what to do in this regard, how we are going to preview. First, always remember, read the title of the book. What is the name of the book? Because name also suggests you. All right, so don't forget about reading the title carefully. Understand its words, understand the meaning of the title. Second step, read name of the author. What is the name of the author? Who has written this book? Because authors also have certain credentials. There are famous people who have written different books. So they have certain legacy behind them. They have certain background and people know what kind of writers they are. So it also helps you to decide either you have to read the book or not. Third one. That is fine if it is fiction or not non-fiction. Okay, some books are fiction. They are imagination of the author. And sometimes the author is using the reality. It's telling you the reality. Sometimes it's narrating you the reality. So you have to decide either it is a true story, either it is a true episode, or it is totally imagination. It is totally fiction, right? Fourth one, find what the book is about. Now, you have to go through the title page, or sorry, not title page, it is your external cover, back side of that cover, where you will find certain description about the book, certain review. There you will try to find what the book is about. Either it is about history, either it is an autobiography, either it is related to science reality, either it is related to science fiction, it is related to a certain future imagination of the writer, what it is about. So next one. So how you are going to decide, you have to find adjectives, because you know, adjectives describe different thing. So it will, adjectives will describe the book and author, right? So it will help you what kind of book it will be. It will be interesting, it will be boring, it will be fascinating, it will be charming book, or whatever it is. So next step is find what has been written about the author. So you will also try to dig out from the page, from the external title, that what is written about the author, right? So it will also help you to decide either you have to read this book or not. Now we are going to see one example. See, there's a book, this is external cover, and first what you have to do it quickly. You are going to do it in seconds, not more than 30 seconds, right? So first you are going to see the front page. Okay, what is the name of the book? It is The Autobiography of Malcolm Max. Okay, there are two important words. Autobiography, it means it will be a real story. It is about the real life of a certain person. Who's that person? Yes, it is Malcolm Max. Okay, who was Malcolm Max? Yes, great name, a great person in American history who did a lot for the freedom of American, especially African American rights. And now move to the writer. Who is the writer? Yes, Alex Haley. Yes, who is Alex Haley? There is one reference given, Roots. He's a person who wrote very famous novel Roots, that is about African Americans' freedom and their fight and how they survived, how they were treated. So now we'll go back to the back page. It is okay, Malcolm X. I'm not going to read the whole page. Okay, there is word articulated. Okay, then you have got word anger, the struggle. Okay, then blacks in 60s, all right. And then there's another word, classic of modern America, and then violent times. It means these words are telling you that this is the story of a person whose name is Malcolm Max, and he was very prominent person in the 60s in the United States of America, and what he did during that violent times, the times when there were chaos everywhere in the United States of America. He worked well. He worked for the freedom of Americans. What were those Americans? Yes, African Americans. And find another one. Okay, passion. All right, then you can also find painful truth. So it was the truth, but it's very painful. Thousands and thousands of people sacrificed their lives for their freedom, for the rights to survive in that, to excel this in that society, to work against the supremacy of white people there. So again, extraordinary, brilliant. Okay, this is excellent book, and it is rated well by different people. New York Times. Okay, this is prominent newspaper. So if it is telling this, so it means it is very excellent book. So find another word here. Permanent place shows you that yes, you cannot exclude this book from the history of American literature or American writings. And then you will find that, okay, it's about the author and his another masterpiece, Roots. So in this way, you have understood that, okay, this book is about Malcolm X, and it is a biography. It is not a fiction. It's written by Alex Haley, was very famous because he wrote Roots. It was also televised. And then there are certain words which are telling you that, okay, it's the true story of true freedom fight of an African American for the rights of his brothers, right? And this book has been the part, or has got the place in the literature of United States of America. So if you are interested in reading autobiographies and reading about histories, so that book will suit you. And if you want to write a research, it will also become a very good reference book for you. I think I have tried my best to explain this, how to preview and how to predict a book and to decide either you have to read this book or not. And I'm very thankful to you for your patience. Take care of yourself. I love it.